transition fundamentals, the goal is to get people from 7-mode or even other competitor systems. We have three phases: identify, design, and implement. So we do environmental discovery and define the scope. We group volumes that make sense in what order to migrate, whether it's partial or everything at once, or by business unit or by application. We then do our design. We transition plan. We determine the optimal methods and any upgrades we need to do, and we do training with our customers too to make sure you understand the new way of doing things and the better, different way of doing it with cluster data on tap. Then we size and design things appropriately. One thing we're really proud of, whether it's the newsroom or Jet Propulsion Lab or the customers we work with here, is that you don't find our customers coming back, oh, this thing isn't meeting my performance requirement. As you know, all the SEs in here, we will go gather as much information as we can to size things properly. So we can't stress that enough, that it's not about where's the sale at. Is it something that's going to work today and in 5 years for you? So we take our sizing here very seriously, whether it's VMware, NetApp, Cisco, the firewalls with Palo Alto, all those different things. We are very careful to make sure we do the right thing there. Part of our culture again. So implementation, we deploy and configure, and then we do the data migrations and cutovers, any environmental upgrades, and then additional staff training for any kind of staff maintaining it or run teams that are continuing to run. And then we also document procedures, which we spend a lot of time building, run books for customers or customize things and how to for help desk guys. So let's go over the migration tools, and I'm going to go through quickly without reading them for you. There's replication using native technology, SnapMirror, with a 7-mode transition tool. There are appliance-based migrations using a NAS appliance or a SAN appliance. You can use application tools or non-NetApp host-based tools. So let's talk about application tools. They provide zero downtime. Our VMware customers are some of the easiest to migrate because we put the new system in. Storage vMotion is a wonderful thing. It makes the migrations to cluster data on tap very easy. So now we deal with architecture and training, not migration challenges. And very similar with Oracle and DAG and those type of things with availability groups with SQL and Exchange. They don't preserve snapshot copies is one thing to note. However, we can turn deduplication and snapshots on and let those build over time during the migration. 7-mode transition tool, by far, it's the premier product we work with. It will take any source 7-mode system and do cutovers and configurations on the CDOT cluster. So in this case, we don't have to recreate a lot. We do our planning and make sure we meet all the criteria. Oh, sorry, question?
On the last slide, is there any consideration for considering using Hyper-V or Citrix or anything in the future other than VMware?
Well, yeah, I mean, Hyper-V can do this very similar. You can migrate things as well. And Citrix Zen as well, you can move, yeah. Yeah, so I didn't put that in the cloud slide had that, but that's a good question. And, Hyper-V supports SMB3. VMware always support all the protocols as well. So, and they're all supported on NetApp. But, it's a question, do you want to do a host base? It takes time to migrate every data store. Maybe you want to do it all at once. And then we could use this tool to migrate those as well. So the great thing about this tool is it not only configures everything, but it preserves all our storage efficiencies and our snapshots are all kept. So everything you had before, you have on the target. Rapid data, this was a cache IQ acquisition several years ago from NetApp. What this does is takes NFS data and restructures it. The DTA 2800, this is for SAN migrations. It's a tap type device that will tap in and copy LUNs in the background and then do near online cutovers. We don't use this as much with 8.3 now because it supports SAN migrations. But this is a very, very fast way with minimal downtime to do upgrades. And that's a QLogic OEM that NetApp has. Non-host-based migration, logical volume managers, rsync, robocopy. We work a lot with peer software, and there's also Data Dynamics Storage X. And very similar to application-based, they don't preserve snapshots or efficiencies, but we can re-enable those at migration.